Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of GTA 5, the story mode, of course. I don't know. I got this car back, and Lester's called us to the garment factory after we helped Solomon out with his little problem of getting his ass kicked by some younger gentleman.
What's going on? Oh, just enjoying a little labor dispute. See, we're about to do something really, really bad. So I need to present myself as a proper textile magnet.
So you stop making anything?
Nothing looks more suspicious in America than someone who's actually prepared to make something.
Jesus.
What about you?
Oh. Fucking Trevor. We're having some problems.
Brad.
Yeah, what else?
Anyway, the Union Depository is on hold for now. Can't do it without him, especially now that he knows.
Thank God you guys are here. You alone?
Davey, where's your boyfriend Steve?
He's on his way up. Yeah, they're up here. Listen, the shit's about to hit the fan.
Our entire lives together has been nothing but a series of fans and shits.
Sort this problem out for me, and I will get Mr. Leisureware off your back.
And if we don't?
Then I will go to jail and you will get shot.
Ah, fuck you, Dave. I've heard it all before.
Not like this, you haven't.
Has he briefed you?
Oh, why, yes, he has. He told us that if we do what you say, then together we can take down the big bad wolf that is government corruption.
Yeah, and if you don't, we're all gonna fry, because the agency's onto us. I've even got some fools in our own bureau that are questioning my methods. Think I'm a liar, a cheater, some kind of a killer and a thief!
So?
So, there's some, evidence, and I need you guys to find out what they know.
All right, so what? You want Lester here to hack into the system, wipe it all clean?
Oh, no, no, that will not work. The only way to access it is through your buildings.
Fuck me.
Michael, you'd be doing me a very big favor. And if you do this, I will make sure that all your files are deleted. I promise you.
Hey! It's the last thing we do, and we're done. Period.
Of course! I'm a man of my word! Dave, let's go!
Come on, Lester, let's go.
Good luck, gentlemen.
Oh, ugh, well, shit.
Take us to the bureau, parking garage entrance.
Well, we're gonna have to do some smart shit, probably, to take out a FBI building.
Do this? Scope it out?
Not really, but I thought we'd start by finding a way into the building.
Ah.
Through the parking lot?
No. We're waiting for someone to come out of it. A janitor.
All right. And how's that gonna get us in?
Well, the janitors are all on temp contracts. They get replaced when their backs go or they ask for a day off. So, we find one of these guys,
I see.
Turn him, and that's our in.
Okay. They're a particular guy?
I'm in the temp company's database right now. I found a guy about to clock off. File here.
Oh, goddammit, I'm gonna have to follow a guy.
Molina, license plate 83
I'm gonna frickin' tail someone, aren't I?
And we'll follow him, see what we think.
Sounds good.
Here we are. Let's wait for him.
So, Lester. How are you?
Ooh, what's this? Nope.
So
you're
what
shitting
do you think
me.
About this whole messed up situation?
I think they'll either kill you after this is done, or keep you doing these stupid jobs until they don't have to kill you, because someone else has done it for them.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
That's it?
Probably not.
That's not it.
So what do we do?
Well, what can we do? We do the job. Then maybe you can delete the files when you're inside, doing whatever else you're doing. That might be a way out.
Yeah, well, a way out is exactly what I need.
Something's coming. This is not the car we're looking for.
Oh, that's
it's
a crappy joke, Lester.
Job without financial incentive.
You can't put a price on freedom.
Well, that spur won't be there for the crew. I'm gonna ask Mr. Haynes for a budget. Maybe the leftover cash from the Polito score. We need something.
Yeah, see what you can do.
That's the one. Stay behind him, but don't let him see you.
So what's gonna happen when this guy gets wherever he's going?
He's gonna get his severance package.
I can't tell if that's some creepy euphemism or a plain statement of facts.
It's whatever you want it to be.
Okay.
Oh God.
Take the next right.
Thank you, Lester.
Hey, you mind? Put away the smartphone or pad or whatever the hell that is for a minute. No surfing while I'm trying to tail this guy.
It's work related.
Yeah, well, I'd prefer all hands on deck right now, if it's okay with you. God, you're worse than my son.
You want to break into the FIB's West Coast headquarters, you're gonna need more than a janitor's license plate number. Now let me work on some angles while you, keep this car behind that one in between these white lines.
That's it. I mean, other than a few missing expletives in terms of racial abuse, that was my son in spades.
He's turning left up ahead. I just spoke with Agent Haynes. We've got the budget to pull this off.
Good.
Thank God for that. Who the hell am I gonna hire?
He's pulling up. Park down the block.
If I had a euro... That's depressing for him, isn't it?
Harvey?
Who are you?
The guy with your best interest at heart. Fill your pockets with money, all you gotta do is take a little vacation.
Hey, I work two jobs, man. Take any break I can get. Hey, you want the beer?
Nah, just take the overalls. Oh, and your ID.
It's in there.
Oh, and Harvey, I probably don't need to say this, but you don't play ball, I'll be forced to do something I really don't want to do. Enjoy your beer.
Cool dude, Harvey. Nice guy. Thanks, Harvey. Harvey Dent.
Successful?
Oh, yeah.
We gotta go back to my office.
Alright. Breakneck speed, yes.
Guess you were right. Steve Haynes is a shitty boss.
Hey, I called Frank while you were in there. He's coming to meet us.
Yeah, huh? What do we need him for?
Grunt work. Information gathering.
What information?
The plans to the office. There aren't any digital copies, or if there are, I'm not clever enough to find them. The architect is LS-based, so I thought Frank could tail him and take a hard copy.
Sounds complicated. You sure you need these?
Fucking damn it! No, fuck yourself, get off of me. Damn it, let me in the frickin' canals. Why is there a chopper? Guess we'll just sit here until the cops piss off. Yep, it was Franklin.
Yeah, I do. If I'm gonna find a way to bypass a couple of $100 million worth of government security.
Millions? They blew that much?
Government contracts, license to steal.
Wow. We are in the wrong business.
No, we've just taken the wrong contracts.
I hear that, Lester.
He's already here.
Oh, good. Sup, Franklin.
Hey, what's the problem, dog?
Steve fucking Haynes.
Of course it's Steve fucking Haynes. It's always Steve Haynes.
That is not strictly true. It's either Steve Haynes or it's Trevor. It's his family. It's always one of them.
Yeah, that's true. It is always one of them. Well, fat old fuck with a horrible family and even worse friends. I told you, Franklin, I ain't a good role model.
Yeah, whatever, dawg. It's either this or dealing dime bags. The bullets come cracking at your ass either way.
Thanks.
We need to find out something about this FIB building, a weakness or a way in. Next time I meet a morally destitute, totally delusional, highly corrupt government agent. I hope he's a nice one.
Man, I'm not going in that motherfucker by myself.
No. Nobody is going in. We need to do some recon. We need a little more information.
Shit.
I need the architectural plans. But they're not online anyway, so I'm gonna need paper copies. Now, the architect's name is Chip Peterson. This was his first big commission, and the office is down in Backlot City.
All right. Franklin, you go tell him for a little while, and then we'll talk.
All right, dog, I got you.
Oh my god, really? Fucking hate tailing people. Tailing people sucks balls. Ooh, an M for Mikael. There we go. Now I gotta just drive all the hell the fucking way over there. Yeah, let's go. Explore it. Okay. Going like fucking Mach speed right now.
You entitled piece of shit.
It's not worth it. I'm not gonna go for that armored truck. I said I was sorry. Did I not say, go back in the footage, tell him I was sorry. Alright, you fuckhead. I'm turning into a real fucking bad driver. Turning into an awful driver. Michael mission.
God.
Oh.
Hey.
I'm sorry I spiked you, okay? I get so mad and I can't control things, and then, you know, shit just falls on top of me. My life sucks right now, and I don't know what to do except I want to say I love you and hug it out, but all that wimpy shit is just... Well, I'd say gay, but I have some friends who are gay, so that's not cool anymore. And the ones that I don't really like, it's not because they're gay. So, lame, all right? You are just a lame and angry psycho sometimes. You do bad shit and things. I don't know if I love you, and I'm pretty sure I hate you a little bit, but I'm just so fucking upset that we can't even see each other. And you're just a drunk, lame dad.
You know what? That might just be the nicest thing anybody's ever said to me.
So will you buy me a car?
What?
I mean, not in the so will you buy me a car kind of way, in a completely off-topic can you buy me a car. I mean, firstly, I'm a fat shit that you ruined. And secondly, I will get a job, and I will stop smoking pot, in that sort of way, okay?
I love you too, son. Now, go. Get a job, because I don't have the money to buy you a car. Besides which way, I'm probably gonna be dead in a couple weeks anyway.
Please don't die, okay? It's great catching up with you too, Dad.
Yeah. Hey, how's your mother?
Oh, she's great. No, she's not. She's bored. I mean, all this mesmerizing tantric sex she's been having with a much younger, better built, caring and compassionate man is great and all. What's she gonna do for the other 6 hours of the day?
What the fuck?
I'm just winding you up, you miserable bastard. She's mad at you. She's scared that you're gonna die, and she wants you to go over there and prove that you give a fuck.
All right, all right, all right! I can take a fucking hint. Let's go. We'll get Tracy on the way.
Tracy, on the other hand, she's a star. Sort of.
Mom said she was at the beach.
Oh, dear God. I have another. Oh, I guess that's Starbucks.
So, what's been happening?
Yeah.
You know, I don't know, stuff?
Stuff?
No, I don't know. Well, what's been happening with you?
Thanks. It's
anyone's guess.
Yeah. Yeah, I get it.
You were out of the city?
Sure, you guys were gone, so I thought I'd, you know...
There they are, outside. Come on, let's say hi.
Caffeine, come on. Your colon has been sluggish for weeks.
A little bit less lifestyle guru and a little bit more... Excuse me, I'm trying to write a screenplay.
Shush,
here.
Woman.
Hey, Amanda. Fabian.
Michael.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, Jimmy.
These two, a picture of holistic well-being, I don't think.
Hey.
Maybe they shit once a year between them.
Hey, oh. That's my son!
Amanda, come. I have a new unitard on hold. You must pay for it.
Hey!
Hey!
Buddy, I'm gonna ask politely that you show my wife a little respect.
Red meat has been blocking your chi as well as your digestive tract.
I ain't even gonna go there. I'm gonna ask you one time. Nicely.
Michael, just hit him, please.
Shush, woman!
Anything for you, sweetheart.
I had some really good work there, you dick!
There's a lot more where that came from, Holmes.
Is he alive?
Yeah, he's fine. Listen, Amanda. I'm meaning to say to you, I just...
What he's trying to say, Mom, is that he's a pathetic, old, drunken mess, and he needs you. And you could do a lot better than a prima donna yoga instructor with an anal fixation.
Someone say...
Shut up!
I guess we could try.
All I'm asking for is a shot.
Neutral ground. Dr. Friedlander's office.
It's perfect. All of us. I'll pick up Tracy and bring her there. Meet you?
Fine. All right, you. Come on. Get up, you idiot.
Yoga?
No. No yoga.
Oh, fuck yeah, boys. No yoga.
All right. You know where your sister is, right?
Yeah. wait, but what about that sugar, caffeine, and emulsified pig fat flavored beverage I want?
Another time.
Oh.
Come on, I want one too. Later.
I think Tracy's over at the tattoo parlor.
Oh. Sweet. Let's go, Jimmy. Jimmy Jams.
What? Tracy's getting another tattoo.
No, oh god, no. That Laszlo guy's there.
Laszlo? That asshole? What's he want?
It's Tracy that wants something. She wants to get back on Fame or Shame after you and Uncle T cut her cameo short.
Well, maybe we ought to help her out with that.
Maybe we ought to.
Hey, let me ask you. Back there with your mom. That went okay, didn't it?
Anything that ends with Fabian's burst eardrum is more than okay with me.
Yeah, I mean with me and your mom.
I think it's an important first step in, like, the direction of okay, if you know what I mean. Here's the tattoo shop.
All right, cool. Let's get in there, Jimmy Jam. Jim Jam, Jimmy boy.
What a drunk.
Yeah, I get that a lot.
I'm looking for something hip that, you know, says I'm capable of violence, but I'm awesome in the sack. So listen, babe, if you want to make it in Vinewood, you got to do whatever it takes, even if whatever it takes is a depressed borderline alcoholic who hosts the third most popular talent show amongst the 40-year-old female demographic.
So, you'll let me on the show if I blow you?
Yes, and if you could wear some black lipstick, the little guy loves the goth vibe.
Oh.
Whoa!
Laszlo.
Dude, that was entirely out of context, bro.
Jim, you find the Inkslinger, sit on him. Laszlo here's gonna have a little cosmetic work done.
No, please.
Whoa. Stay put, you lame-ass Mark.
Sure, kid.
What?
Ooh, boy.
Come on, just out
the fun time.
Ow! Are you popping a fucking tent over here, you fucking psycho?
Nose.
Give me a pouty fucking hipster.
Ear time.
Ow!
Oh, that looks pretty. Here, let's get rid of this.
Ooh. Tattoo, you're back. Oh, I see. Is it a dick? Oh my god, it's a dick.
How about I draw those three little pubic hairs on here, too? There we go.
He's got a dick on his back.
Smash you upside the head with it.
Fuck this!
Snip, snip.
Oh, this is a real one-stop shop. When I get nervous, I evacuate my
bowels. No ponytail.
It's seeping out. No, that's my signature, my ponytail. Now I gotta get extensions.
No, what you gotta get is my daughter, whatever she wants.
Yeah, without sucking on your piddle stick.
Look, okay, guys, that was a joke. I'm a clown. I'm a sad, lonely little clown.
Hey. You're gonna put her on your show, and you're gonna make sure she looks good.
Look, okay, I got a lot of juice in this town, but I mean, I'm not a miracle.
Just do it! Yeah.
Exactly, just do it, you shit.
So let's go. We gotta get to the therapist.
So, I'll, like, call you or something, okay? Bye.
Never a family that needs therapy. My ponytail. How do I look? It's not good, is it?
You look fan-fucking-tastic, Laszlo.
It's a tattoo gun. It's one of those skills you pick up in prison. You know, inking your name on your cellie's ass.
Ew. Are you serious?
Come on. No. Not quite.
Ah, good times with the family. Fuck yeah.
Really bad, but yeah, I fucking hate that dude.
Yeah,
excellent.
I know, right? So up his own ass. You're a fucking contortionist. Whoopee.
I contort my junk all day long and I don't act all superior about it. Just a little ashamed and penitent.
Overshare.
Hey, guy was talking smack to your mother.
Well, I applaud you, Pop.
Here, here. You're like finally like using your powers of selfishness and rage for like good. Not
fuck yeah.
Universal good, but like a subjective what's in our best interest kind of good.
Fuck yeah. Awesome. Let's rob somebody.
Do it, Dad.
Yeah, do it.
Enough, okay? I love that we're getting along, but knock it off.
Yeah, don't, like, actually rob a liquor store.
You hit my fucking car!
Shit. Oh, should I hit your car?
That might, like, kill the mood.
Fucking therapy. Let's do that shit.
Hey, how about you just let your mom and me talk, okay? We got some issues we gotta iron out. And seeing as you two aren't into it, you can just sit there and be quiet.
That's cool with me.
I got all the prescriptions I need, at least for the meantime.
Thank you.
Alright, let's do this shit. Enda, where the fuck's your car? Where the fuck did she park?
Amanda!
Hello!
Good to see you again, Michael. I'm so glad. Isn't this great?
Fantastic.
Michael, be positive.
I am being positive. This is me being positive.
Give it up, Michael. The sarcasm. It's one of the reasons I moved out. It's beneath you.
No, it's not, Amanda. Trust me. Nothing's beneath me.
No, normally there's a whore beneath you.
You know, for someone who spends every waking moment working on themselves inside and out, I gotta tell you, the progress has been really fucking slow.
How would you know what progress is like, you stupid murdering shit?
Gee, because all you do is whine at me.
Oh! All I do is whine. Michael, could you please stop murdering people? Michael, could you please stop endangering me and the both of your children? You kill people and then you sit in the sun and drink and feel guilty about it. That is not work.
I don't see you complaining on the way to the fucking bank. I mean, let's face it, Amanda. We're trailer trash, you and me. We were taught to do this.
Get a center, Michael. You have no center.
How about you suck my cock? Huh? No, wait. We'll both get a center before that ever happens.
You are such a fucking animal, a deranged animal.
You fucking ain't right on deranged. How could I not be?
I should have had you locked up years ago, you stupid
Do
shit.
It. Do it. I'll put you in the fucking ground with the rest of them.
And that's really all the time we have.
Oh.
Great.
I think we made some real progress there. Oh, Michael. I hope this goes without saying, but family work is a little more expensive.
What, double?
Squared.
Of course.
Take care now.
Hey. So you gonna come home with me or what?
Guess we'll give it a try.
All right then.
Kids! So, will you drive us home?
Aw, that's nice and heartwarming. Aw, Friedlander, you fucking overcharging shit. Damn it. Alright. That's all good.
I thought,
what?
I don't know, like maybe we still had a ways to go. You know, like maybe we need more time.
Nah, we're good.
For what?
Time to move beyond screaming at each other.
That was cathartic.
Catharsis all over my face.
I don't know what the fuck a cathartic is.
Fuzzy feeling.
Probably just the meds you rated.
Okay. Cathartic. All right. I just don't want it to be more of the same.
Now you're the one making the demands?
No, not demands. I'm saying you're right. Something was broke, and we gotta work at fixing it.
We do. All of us.
Yes, Mom.
For real, peeps.
Because I started to understand something in there. No one else gets this family. Not Dr. Friedlander, or my yoga teacher, or our tennis coach.
or the juice guy, or the dog walker.
Oh, hey.
Or Jimmy's third grade teacher.
Or the trash guy.
Or Dad's proctologist.
Or the guy that thinks he's Jesus on Vespucci Beach.
Or the hippie bum who thinks the world is ending.
We're stuck with each other. I mean, how do you explain faking our deaths, changing our names, the line to the FIB? That monster, Trevor.
There's no explaining, Uncle T.
Nope. Let's go home, family.
Rooms. If you find dead bodies, cheap women, or Trevor Phillips, we're checking into the Rockford Hills Hotel.
Hooray, guys, we did it. We got Michael's family back. 10 out of 10. Meanwhile, oh God. Trevor, you good, mate?
Last one standing. Again.
Excellent. Well, guys, thank y'all so much for watching. We're out of time for this episode, so I thank y'all. Thank y'all, and I'll see all of you in the next video. Goodbye.